वेलकम बैक टू आवर ऑनलाइन क्लास। हाउ आर यू ऑल? यस एट क्लास चिल्ड्रन, वील डू द लेसन पोएम बी थैंकफुल। थैंकफुल मीन्स से थैंक यू, से अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह फॉर एवरीथिंग विच गॉड हैज गिवन अस, आवर टीचर्स हैव गिवन अस, आवर पेरेंट्स हैव गिवन अस। नाउ लेट्स गो थ्रू द बी थैंकफुल दैट यू डोंट ऑलरेडी हैव एनीथिंग यू डिजायर। If you did, what would be to look forward to? Be thankful when you don't know something, for it gives you the opportunity to learn. Be thankful for the difficult times. During those days you grow. Be thankful for your limitations, because they give you opportunities for improvement. Be thankful for each new challenge, okay? Because it will build your strength and character. Why we should be thankful? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our parents, guidance, whoever are guiding us, our elders, teachers, grandparents, neighbors also, whoever, when we go to new job also, we should be thankful to him, her. Why? Because we get a new challenge, new way of life, new method to fight that difficulty. Strength, we gain more strength. Be thankful for the new challenge, for each new challenge, because it will build your strength and character. Be thankful for your mistakes. They will teach you valuable lessons. Be thankful when you are tired and weary, because it means you have made a difference. You are tired means you have really done something good. That's why you are trying to make difference in your life. It's easy to be thankful for the good things. A life of rich fulfillment comes to those who are also thankful for the setbacks. Gratitude can turn a negative into positive. Find a way to be thankful for your troubles, and they can become your blessings. And they can become your blessings from elders you get. If you sort out somebody's problems, when you turn the negative thoughts into positive, you will be able to live a happy life, a healthy life. Next is the lesson at the dead rat. The reading part children will read. The first paragraph, in the city of Ujjain, there was a young merchant called Madananka. He lost his father when he was in his teens, so it was his mother who brought him up with great affection and love. Unfortunately, he turned out to be a vagabond. His mother hoped that he would become a normal and he would settle down if he was married, and so she found a suitable girl and they were married. Every mother has some dreams, isn't it? They give you so much of their time, love, affection, everything, money, isn't it? Moral values, schools, studies of the schools, religious knowledge, that they want their children to be good, like you all, right? A good boy or a good girl. And they want to marry their children in a healthy, happy family. His mother hoped that he would become normal. He was somewhat turned out to, but he was not a very good boy, somewhat bad boy. The mother found a suitable girl and they were married, but Madananda became worse. The boy's name is Madananka. Which city is this? In our story it is described Ujjain city. One day Madananka absconded from his house, deserting his mother and pregnant wife. His mother grieved for him. She was angry, worried, upset. The daughter-in-law, after some time, gave birth to a son. He was named Ratananka. Though poor, Ratananka was brought up with affection and care and given good education. Many poor children also know they have interest, means they get good education. One day when he was 10 years old, his grandmother said to him, "My lad, my boy, your father left all of us in misery, in trouble." So grandmother is telling to his grandson, what's the name of that boy? Ratananka. His father was Madananka left them. So mother told, grandmother explained that boy, that your father left us in trouble, but we give you good education, good family values, moral values. We two women, mother and his dadi, grandmother, have brought you up with whatever little money and jewelry we had. but we don't have anything to fall back upon. Okay, now we don't have anything else for you. So you take up some business to evoke out a living. In the neighboring villages, there is a well-to-do merchant called Rakshadatta. Now, Dadi tells, now you are grown up, you know your mother and I have given you the education which we felt the best, and the jewelry we have is very little. We spent it only on your studies and all. Now you take up a business and go to a nearby village where well-known merchant, businessman. What's the name of that man? Yakshadatta. Go and meet him, who lends money to the poor but capable person. You can borrow money from him, but he knows who is good in his work, in his business, then only he'll give him. You go to him, Dadi's telling him. Explain to him our condition and borrow some money so that you can start some business for your livelihood. Isn't it? Every parents, grandparents explain their children, isn't it? Now you do like this, guide them. You start this job, you go there, you ask him for your support. Following the instructions of his grandmother, Ratananka went to Yashodatta. At that time, Yashodatta, the rich merchant, was taking a stroll. He was taking rest. Knowing him to be Yakshadatta, Ratananka approached him and said, "Sir, I am a poor merchant boy. My father deserted us before I was born. My grandmother and my mother have brought me up with great difficulty. We have heard your fame and generosity, kindness, your name." Like, he's a big, profound, everyone knows him, this good businessman. "In helping people of our poor status, I request you to lend me some money for my business. And I promise to repay the amount soon." Is it clear, children? Hearing Ratnanka, Yakshadatta laughed, looked around and pointed towards a dead rat lying in the street. Said, "Lo, my boy." He's laughing. I don't know why. Let's find out. "That dead rat is the capital which I can lend you. You take it away and do some trade with it." This dead rat he wants to give him for business. Go and earn money from him. "To an intelligent man, it will fetch millions. And even if I get millions, to an unintelligent man, it will be of no use." Ratananka thought for a minute and then took the dead rat as a favor form from Rakshadatta. Still, he took it as a challenge and he took it, that dead rat, as for business. He made a cup of leaf and placed the dead rat in that cup. Got it? He carried it through the streets crying, "A rat for sale." See the smartness of the boy. One merchant who was taming a cat is in order to get rid of rats. That way, a menace in his shop. A rat for sale. Dead rat, he's selling it. Nowadays, everything is happening online. We are telling, you know, that's what is there in our story. One merchant who was taming a cat, trying to hold the cat, catch the cat, in order to get rid of the rats. That way, a menace in his shop, purchased that dead rat as prey for his cat and gave him a handful of Bengal gram, chana dal. Ratananka took that Bengal gram home and soaked it in water. Next morning, he added some salt and pepper to the soaked and swollen Bengal gram, took the drinking water in an earthen pitch, went outside the city and sat under the tree. Okay, Ratananka took the Bengal gram home, soaked it in the water. See how smartly that boy is doing the work. He laughed, isn't it? And gave him a dead rat, but still he's doing some business out of it. Next morning, he added some salt and pepper to the soaked and swollen Bengal gram, took drinking water in an earthen pitcher, isn't it? Went out the city and sat under the shade of a tree and offered each woodpecker some Bengal gram and cold water. See his tricks. The hungry and thirsty woodpeckers were pleased with Ratnanaka's service, gave him 2 pieces of firewood each. By evening, the pieces piled up into a big heap. It became a big wooden rock, which Ratnananda sold away for 2 rupees in the city. Out of the 2 rupees, Ratnanka gave one to his grandmother towards saving, and with the other rupee he purchased a kancham, a kind of measuring unit of grains of Bengal gram, something to measure in the kirana store and all. Kancham. Out of this he soaked 1 kilo every day and sat under the same tree with cold water. See the, how you cannot think also. We think dead rat, what he is giving. If I tell you all, you all will throw away in the tree. Isn't it? The dead rat he gave, he is doing so much of business profit. Smart boy. In this way, he collected many cartloads of fuel within a month. Fortunately, there was incessant rains for 10 days. As a result, there was scarcity of firewood in the city. The firewood which Ratnanka had collected fetched him 100 gold coins. He became a rich boy now. With that money, Ratnanka opened a firewood stall and began dealing in timber. From timber to cloth, and from cloth to grain again, and the grains to diamonds. His business progressed rapidly, very quickly, very lucky this boy was. Within a couple of years, Ratnanka became one of the leading merchants in that city. One day, Ratnanka got a rat made of gold, weighing 1 kilo. Its eyes were made of rubies, eyes were made of sapphire, and it had a diamond chain around its neck. It was kept in silver trap and carried in procession with pomp. Isn't it? See how he's taking in the plate. Ratnanka was leading the procession. When he reached the residence of Rakshadatta, he asked the procession to halt. Taking the track to Yakshadatta's home came, so he waited, told all of them to stop there. Hearing the band and the noise of the procession, Yakshadatta came out of his house and inquired what all that pomp and hubbub was that about. Ratnanka addressed Yakshadatta thus, "Sir, I became a millionaire by your grace. 2 years back, when I came to you for a loan, you gave me a dead rat. Your wise saying and the capital which I borrowed from you made me a rich man." Now he's going and answering him, showing him the rat and explaining him how he became rich. "Now I have come to repay your debt in the shape of golden rat. Kindly accept this as a symbol of gratitude." You can do this, a symbol of my gratitude. Yakshadatta was amazed. He was very shocked to hear his story. He was very pleased with this intelligence and gratitude of Ratnanka. Do you understand? Make use of each and everything smartly, and today's world is smart world, not hard work. We all want smart work. See the homework for today. What did mother do to make Madananka normal and settled in life? What kind of man was Yakshadatta? What did Ratnanka do with the dead rat? Send me the homeworks by 5:30 or 6 in the evening. Assalamu alaikum. Thank you, children. See you.